Yeah, baby. Lights in the back are very cool. It's quite an interesting little sound. So Eric and I, who have R1Ts on order, got some intel that Rivian was storing some R1Ts downtown in Atlanta at a temporary base before moving them to another hidden secret location where they were going to go out directly to customers. And for anybody worrying that they're not ramping up production, this was pretty reasonable evidence, well away from the Illinois factory, that that is not the case. Production is definitely on the up, and we were quite surprised to see up to about 25 Rivians all sat there, all looked immaculate, fully production ready, and we chatted to some of the Rivian staff who confirmed that these vehicles will be going out to customers imminently. We were able to have a very good look around the vehicle, and we were both suitably impressed with things like the shut lines of the doors. The panel gaps were very equidistant all the way around. The fit and finish, the quality of the paint was very good. The interiors looked absolutely awesome. Unfortunately, we weren't able to actually sit in any of the vehicles because they are actually customer vehicles, but they really look very nice quality, very nice finish. And the big screen in the center of the dashboard looked really, really nice. And it's definitely got an air of quality, and the fit and finish, as I say, seem to be pretty exemplary. In terms of size, it was actually slightly bigger than we both thought. We keep on hearing that it was kind of Tacoma size, but if anything, we felt it was very much like a full-size truck. And in fact, if the Cybertruck is any larger, which I also have on order, that probably won't fit in my garage because the Rivian will be a fairly tight fit, I'm sure. But nice and spacious for four huge adults, at least, if not five. And the bed is plenty long enough for usual DIY stroke adventure type things. In terms of lighting, that looked awesome. I love the vertical lights, lots of detail in terms of the Rivian logos internally, and just intricacies of that design. And also the rear light, we saw a vehicle putting out that when you touch the brake, that whole back end in terms of the tailgate just illuminates beautifully. And it was very, very nice. It actually sounded nice as well. When they pulled away, there was no kind of creaks and rattles or anything like that. It was very, very smooth, very quiet, very effortless. Just this electric whooshing noise. And they just wafted along. We really totally and utterly lucked out, because when we got there, there just happened to be about 25 of them, about 20 outside, probably about kind of 15, 16 in a row, and then about 10 in about four or five in a back compound, and again several indoors, but we were able to see because the shutter was open, and certainly plenty of vehicles there. And while we were kind of looking around, they started taking the vehicles, not because we were there, they were being very accommodating to us, but because they had to be moved to the other locations. And it was just nice to see them get in and become illuminated and move off. And in fact, I haven't seen any videos on YouTube yet of this kind of volume of Rivian trucks outside the plant in Normal itself. We've seen some vehicles at delivery centres at various locations, but it's typically only kind of two or three, you know, trucks. These were obviously in volume. There were shed loads there. And that was great for us because we wanted to see the kind of colours and the difference between the wheels, etc. And I personally have a Rivian Blue on order with the 20s in silver and black. And Eric has a first edition, and there were plenty of launch green first edition vehicles to look at here. There was also white, which I love in pictures and thought looked great in the flesh, but not quite as excited about it once I saw it in the flesh. And L-cap, and L-cap looked very, very classy. A little bit understated, but very, very classy. And very unusual and slightly disappointing for us was the fact that it wasn't blue skies and sunshine, which it typically is in Georgia, which would have made the metallic paint fleck pop that little bit more and give us a truer picture. But in essence, all the colours were nice. You know, the launch green's pretty nice. The Rivian Blue is great. The white was lovely. The L cap is very classy. Bit disappointing I couldn't see a silver, but you can't have everything, okay? It was a great day, even if we had to stand in the rain a little bit and take some pictures. And anyway, just sharing for you guys, if you have one on order, I'd say keep your order in, keep confident about their ability to ramp up production, and in terms of build quality and comfort and the vehicle, I mean, it's just going to be wonderful, wonderful. If you hang out on YouTube a lot, I would check out Rivian Stories. They are a great channel for Rivian, great bunch of guys. We love watching their podcasts and seeing them interview people who are now starting to get their Rivians and give feedback on the company and how everything is going Rivian wise. So if you're a Rivian fanboy, you need to check out Rivian Stories on our YouTube channel. Big shout out to Skylar and all those guys. Keep up the good work. Thank you for that. So that's it today, just short video, and I just let you know that Eric and I are still happy to have our Rivian's on order. We believe in the company. In fact, we're shareholders in the company as well now. And can't wait really to get our trucks. Eric should have his probably in 2 or 3 months. He's a launch edition guy, and mine will probably be significantly longer, probably the end of next year. But we'll see how they go, and looking forward to getting my truck, and pretty excited about it. Yeah, Rivian done a good job, and hope they go from strength to strength.
Hey you, if you want to become one of the Ride On people, don't forget to subscribe. Ride often, ride carefully, ride on.